Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We know that one of the dua we should be repeating in the last 10 nights of Ramadan is what's narrated by Aisha from the Prophet alayhi wasalam, when she asked him, what is the one dua that if I can make in the last 10 days, I should make? And he said, to say, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. I think all of us know the dua, and I think all of us are attempting to make the dua as much as possible. But what does it mean? So here we're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for al-afu. And some people translate al-afu as forgiveness. But there is a subtle difference between maghfira and afu. Maghfira can be translated as forgiveness. And the word maghfira comes from the root word mighfar. And mighfar means a helmet. Now, if we look at the two goals of a helmet, what does a helmet do for us? Well, one, it covers the head, and the other, it protects us. It protects the head as well. Likewise, forgiveness is supposed to serve these two goals. Forgiveness, basically, means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cover your sin, so people would not know about it. But it also means that He's going to protect you from the ill effects of sins, because every sin has an ill effect, has a bad effect on you and your life. So that is the meaning of forgiveness. Al-afu is a little different. Al-afu is even greater than that. Because when it comes to maghfira or forgiveness, the sin is there, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wipes away the effect of it. All right? So it is there, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is protecting you from its effects. When it comes to afu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala totally erases the sin. And it is as if it never existed. So maybe a better translation for afu would be something like a pardon, a general pardon. Also, maybe emancipation or amnesty is a good word also. So amnesty in the sense that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you this general pardon as if you've never committed the sin. And this is really what we're aiming at in the month of Ramadan. So when you say, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. Oh Allah, you are afu. So afu, by the way, is one of the names of Allah. The fact that He does this afu, this pardon, this amnesty. And you love to do that. Tuhibbul afwa. Fa'afu anni. So you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you this afu, this amnesty in the nights of Ramadan. Now, there's an important principle here that we have to keep in mind. Because some people, what they do, they just focus on the dua. You know, it's a hadith from the Prophet alayhi wasalam, of course. And they keep repeating the dua, which is great. But we have to be mindful of an important concept, which is a concept of reciprocity. The fact that we should practice afu ourselves on other people so that we deserve the afu from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's a really important concept. It is mentioned in the Quran, it is mentioned in the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salam, and not just the afu, but also in a general sense, maghfira and rahmah as well. Mercy, compassion, and forgiveness. For example, in Surah An-Nur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Let them give this pardon to other people and forgive. Don't you like Allah to forgive you? So you see this reciprocity. If you're expecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you, you have to forgive people. Likewise, in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, the famous hadith, إِرْحَمُوا مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَرْحَمْكُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ. Have mercy on the people of earth so that you deserve the mercy of God upon you. So that the one in the heavens will have mercy upon you, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is important because, like I said, we kind of forget that. And we just focus on the dua and we forget one of the important conditions for this dua to be answered. Nowadays, unfortunately, many Muslims might live in a culture of a bit of like hatred and vengeance. And we don't normally think of afu. We're always thinking of how we can spite our enemies, whoever that is. Even if you look at the dua itself, the dua we make, a lot of the dua is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get rid of this, or to wipe this out, or to take care of this supposed enemy, and so on. And this does not reflect the spirit of Islam, the spirit of peace, and the spirit of forgiveness and pardon. So it is essential in the month of Ramadan, when we do these dua, when we make those dua, that we also think of this, that this is not just something I utter in my mouth, but it is also accompanied by an action. So how about this? And this does not take any physical act. It has to happen inside of us, in the heart. I'm sure many of us might have certain grudges towards certain people. Many times our own families or friends or relatives. Today and tonight and these nights is a time to commit to have this pardon. Don't even ask for an apology, because pardon is above that. This afu, this concept of afu, is above going and expecting somebody to apologize to you so that you can forgive them. So why don't we practice afu at least on the people closest to us that we've not talked to in a while, the people that we don't want to associate with, the people we have grudges against, and maybe because they did something to us in the past. But wanting to spite them or to get back at them, this is totally the opposite of the concept of afu. So one thing that we all can do in these nights, and it happens within us in our hearts, is to practice afu toward the people that we may not like, or the people that they've wronged us in the past, or the people that we've not talked to recently, whereas we should have. And then practice the dua and making the dua so that at least our words and actions are going in cohesion, and they're going together. And inshallah, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our dua successful and to make it effective, because that's what we want. We want a dua to be effective and to be answerable by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum.